There's only one pronghorn and it's only found in North America. There's nothing like them anywhere in the world. My name is Sean Gray and I'm the Mule Deer and Pronghorn Program Leader for Texas Parks and Wildlife Department.
Sean is on a mission to solve a mystery. He and many other biologists are trying to understand why the pronghorn population in the Big Bend region of Texas took a sudden plunge.
We just pulled the right kidney.
Through extensive research, biologists are understanding the factors of the decline and how they interact with one another. One fact is known. Drought has definitely contributed to the problem. As part of their efforts to help supplement the population, biologists are capturing and translocating pronghorns from the panhandle to areas just north of the Big Bend. Catching the fastest land mammal in North America is not easy. Of the 200 captured, 52 of the antelope are given satellite receiving radio collars that will help with the research. After a 9-hour drive, the pronghorn are released in their new home.
Trying to get into the mind of a pronghorn is very difficult. However, using the new technology, the new satellite collars, will help us defining those answers that we really need. We noticed that pronghorn were concentrating or would run into a fence and they couldn't find a passage through the fence. That animal would stay in a corner. Pronghorn will not jump a fence. They'd want to go underneath the fence. Coyotes have figured this out. This is a map of the Trans-Pecos with all of the GPS locations from the pronghorn that we translocated. This is a zoomed in image of fences and multiple animal GPS locations. So we have pronghorn locations up and down this fence line here. And when they get bunched up in a fence corner, that's when problems really start to happen. And we had several of our pronghorn get killed by coyotes in fence corners.
While the satellite data from the collars showed the scientists a problem, it also helped them find a solution.
Here we have a fence corner, and using our GPS collars, we observe many of our pronghorn being stuck in fence corners. And so what we did was we raised the bottom strand of this 5-strand barbed wire fence that was originally about 12 inches off the ground to at least 18 inches off the ground to allow pronghorn to move freely. This fence modification keeps pronghorn from being trapped in fence corners. The net result is pronghorn can access more country, and it's also decreased the amount of predation that's going on as well. We're learning a tremendous amount each day, and hopefully we're getting closer and closer and closer to finding those answers that we really need to help these populations flourish again.